Seriously, I stopped using Google Authenticator and I think you should too. Here's why. By this point, you already know that two-factor authentication is the best way for the average person to secure their online accounts. For the past few years, Google has positioned itself as the standard for this kind of security authentication, and up until recently, I've been a faithful user of the Google Authenticator app. But no more. I am seriously fed up. The Google app has now been deleted from my phone. Oh, sorry. That's not entirely true. I've kept it on my phone while I'm doing this video, but once this video goes live, the app will be deleted forever from my devices. What's absolutely crazy, is mind-boggling, is that the reason I'm deleting Google Authenticator is because it's not secure. It's a security app that's unbelievably insecure. There are two important reasons for this. First, Google Authenticator does not allow you to lock the app. Let's take your banking app as an example. If somebody has access to your phone, that doesn't mean they can automatically log on to your bank account. They still need your password in order to do so. But that's not the case with Google Authenticator. Anybody who has access to your phone or is able to hack their way into that first 6-digit passcode is gonna have full access to all of your 2FA keys without any additional passcode to get into that app. And that is not a secure way to do it. Secondly, and probably equally importantly, Google Authenticator does not allow for any kind of backup of all of these security codes. That means that if you lose your device, or if it gets stolen, or if you just lose access to Google Authenticator while you're switching phones and something like that, you've just lost access to all of your online accounts. Now, unless you've kept all of your backup codes when you first set up your 2FA accounts, which, let's be honest, a lot of us haven't done that very well. Google has no backup of this file that you can now upload and reuse, and so it is very, very dangerous. It's putting all of your eggs in one basket. So what are the alternatives? Well, there are three primary alternatives that I recommend. There's plenty more out there, but these are the three that I really like, and I'm gonna share them with you one by one here. You'll notice as I open the Authy app that I have to enter a PIN code in order to get access to my 2FA keys. And this is an important security feature that you'll find with Authy, with Microsoft Authenticator, and even with 1Password, the three apps that I'm gonna share with you right now. And that means that even if somebody has access to your phone and it's unlocked, that doesn't mean they're automatically gonna have access to your 2FA keys. And that's something that Google Authenticator doesn't have, and it should. And once I get in here, Authy and others have multi-device support, which means that you can have this downloaded and all your 2FA keys synced between different devices, including your desktop. So I've downloaded the desktop app for Authy, and here you can see that I've already synced all of the different 2FA tokens, and now instead of having to pull out my phone whenever I need to get a 2FA key and I'm on my laptop or my desktop, I can open up the app here instead. And that's a convenience factor. Maybe it's not quite as secure to have that syncing happening between devices, so that's entirely up to you whether you want to. You can turn off multi-device support if you'd like on Authy. That happens within the security settings. But I do like that you can sync up and it's an encrypted file, and that way if you do have your phone lost or stolen, you can now download that synced file and you still have all your 2FA keys. You don't have to go through that recovery process. The app is passcode protected and it's just a beautiful design. I like how it's, you know, they use the logos of all the different logins that I'm going to use instead of having to scroll through in Google Authenticator like you saw earlier. If I'm opening up Microsoft Authenticator, it's pretty much the exact same thing, where I can use my Face ID, Authy's the same way. You can use any type of biometric data that your device allows for in order to unlock the app itself. And then you can look in, get your codes, copy those codes if you want. Within the Microsoft Authenticator, if you go into the settings here, you'll find that they do allow for iCloud backup. So perhaps you don't want to use Authy's backup, maybe you don't trust them for some reason, and I completely understand. Well, you can use the iCloud backup on Microsoft Authenticator to make sure that you are backing up an encrypted file of all your 2FA keys to your iCloud account. So it's not going to Microsoft, it's not going to Authy, it's your iCloud account. Now, Microsoft Authenticator, in order to use that feature, in order to use the autofill feature or anything like that, you have to actually create, or you have to have a Microsoft account. That's a little annoying to me. It's not that big of a deal. You can just create an account for Microsoft through the app and then use that to take advantage of the different features. That's something that Authy doesn't require. However, Authy does require that you use your phone number to register your device. And so there's, again, a little bit of that security feature there where you're getting your phone number attached to your 2FA keys. And yeah, It's kind of up to you how you want to deal with that. The final one that I like and the one that I use most often is 1Password. Now this isn't a paid, this is the only one of the three that I'm sharing with you that is a paid premium option, but I already use 1Password for my passwords, for creating passwords, storing passwords, and auto-filling them on all of my devices. So this is just an added bonus where I can scan in any of the 2FA codes and now it's part of my password encrypted vault. Now, of course, again, there are security risks involved in that because I'm putting all my eggs in one basket. There are some people that would prefer to do their passwords with one and their 2FA codes with another app, but I don't mind doing it with my password manager 1Password because they do just make it very simple. They actually copy and paste, and when I'm using my desktop, you can notice that they automatically fill in that one-time code if it's one of my logins that asks for the one-time code for 2FA, and that's, again, really convenient. I like that. It gets synced between all of my different devices and it makes it really easy. So Authy, Microsoft Authenticator, and 1Password are excellent alternatives to Google Authenticator that are much more secure, they're much easier to use, and frankly, they're much more beautifully designed apps in the end. So that's what I recommend. Go ahead and start making that switch because the last thing you want is to get caught with your Google Authenticator app and your phone being stolen or lost or somehow losing that data because it's not synced up and you don't have an easy way to recover any of those codes, and that is a terrible position to be in. I definitely don't want to find you there. If this video has been helpful, give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching. If you have questions, I try to answer all of those in the comments below. And as always, subscribe to this All Things Secure YouTube channel for more great tips and tricks related to your online security.